Are you ready to learn how to make basic transitions in multilayer? Well, I'd recommend practicing what I'm doing simultaneously, because if you try to do everything at the end, you might forget. Now, let's get started. To begin, add the two scenes for this transition. If you don't know how to add scenes, check out our course called Basic Concepts. Go to the first scene and open multilayer. Start with a slight transition. Add a path keyframe near the end of the clip, and then slide the clip at the very end. This is what it looks like so far. Notice my picture bounces back a little bit. The paths can be changed to straight here, so it won't do that. Don't forget to select a mirror effect. Then go back to the keyframe screen to add one of our custom graphs to the transition, or create your own. Not sure what custom graphs are? Well, these graphs are used to control the speed of the transitions. So for example, this graph shows that the transition will start slow and end fast, whereas this one shows the opposite. If you're just starting to learn how to use graphs, here's a pro tip. If you like one of our custom graphs, but want more control, first recreate the graph. Then add control points and move them on the grid to your liking. Remember that the graph for the first part of the transition needs to start slow and end fast. Once you've added a graph and are satisfied with the result, go back to the layer screen, use track and blur, and tap create. Now repeat this process with the next clip. Slide the clip in the opposite direction the transition ended on in the first keyframe. To finish off, add another keyframe some frames later by tapping options and centering the layer. Remember that for the second part of the transition, the graph needs to start fast and end slow. Don't forget to use mirroring and to add tracking blur. Here is the final result. To make a spin, zoom or flip transition, the process is mostly the same. However, instead of sliding the clip at the start and end, you'll want to adjust the rotation slider for a spin, the size slider for a zoom, or the rotation slider for a flip. Also, remember to add the graph in the corresponding place. For instance, this is where to add the graph for opacity, and here for the graph for size. Now it's time to practice and show the rest of the VStar community what you've learned. To share your own transitions with the rest of the VStar community, don't forget to add the hashtag VStarSchool to your Reddits on Instagram and TikTok. If you have any further questions about this lesson, you can always ask in the discussion group, or if you prefer, you can contact us through the app by tapping on the question mark button and then support. To download the material used, check out the contents of this lesson. Well, we have reached the end of the lesson and almost the end of the course, and now that you know everything about basic transitions, I have one last assignment for you. See you in the last lesson of the course.